Thank you. Yes, very warm welcome back to the Royal Danish Academy of Music here in Copenhagen, where we're about to bring you the String Quartet final from the 2023 Carl Nielsen International Chamber Music Competition. Well, we already experienced some drama today. The Wind Quintet category was won a few hours ago here in this very concert hall by Ensemble Astera from Switzerland after a fantastic performance of Carl Nielsen's Wind Quintet. They returned to Switzerland €15,000 richer, but which of the string quartets will win that €15,000 first prize? We shall know within the next few hours. First, we're hearing from the Hanna Quartet from Munich. Now, this ensemble gave us Nielsen's Opus 5 string quartet at its first appearance in the competition back on Thursday, and it's going to play again from that piece, the third movement, the Allegretto Scherzando, in its final appearance here, followed by Beethoven's string quartet, Opus 132. The stakes rise, of course, in this final, and Beethoven, of course, demands also so much from those musicians who choose to play him. So many obstacles in a score like that for the Opus 132 string quartet. So many decisions need to be made, so much tension in the music. And yet, in this piece, that incredibly, unspeakably beautiful slow movement at the heart of it, the Molto Adagio that's known as Beethoven's Heiliger Dankegesang, his song of thanks, in which his profound joy and gratitude for respite from his illness is expressed via music that seems so slow and yet does change meter and mood relatively frequently. The sort of ambiguity that Beethoven finds in that music by using an F major scale with a B natural replacing the B flat, one of so many devices that he uses to create music that seems to have come from deep within himself and from some very, very profound place within himself. But we'll hear all five movements of the piece from this young quartet from Munich. They'll need to give us a sense of its architecture as well as to bring its notes off the page with distinction, and they'll need to impress judges who have serious form with this music, including Clive Greensmith, the chair of the jury, of course, cellist of the Tokyo Quartet, Sergei Bresler of the Jerusalem String Quartet, and Maria Bitlock from the Elias String Quartet, also joining them, Gunvor Sim, the Danish violinist from the Nightingale String Quartet and section leader of the second violins of the Danish National Symphony Orchestra, and Berit Kardas, violist from the Vertavo String Quartet. So here they come, the Hanna Quartet from Munich. They rotated first and second violin chairs in the first round so that the violinists were in different positions. They gave us so much verve, authenticity, and energy in their Nielsen in the first round, and then in round two, much the same in this Mendelssohn, that they really took it quite a lick, the Mendelssohn second string quartet, propulsive joy, and then real naturalness and flair they brought to their Bartok. So they start with the Allegretto Scherzando from Nielsen's string quartet, Opus 5, his second, the Hanna Quartet from Munich. Thank you. Allegretto scherzando from Carl Nielsen's String Quartet No. 2, Opus 5. And although we consider that movement one of the lighter movements of that quartet, there's still so much in it, and a reminder that Nielsen's music is so often a game of tug between song and dance. Now, that was merely an hors d'oeuvre, because here we have now a performance of one of the great monuments of the string quartet literature. Beethoven's String Quartet number 15, Opus 132. Played for us by the Hanna Quartet from Munich, and the first violinist, the two violinists have stayed in position, unlike previous rounds. And just a little bit of final preparation before they play their Beethoven, the Hanna Quartet from Munich.
Thank you. Thank you.
What an extraordinary piece of music that is, finally reaching the safety of E major, but still a sense of uncertainty hanging over those emphatic final bars of Beethoven's String Quartet number 15, opus 132. Played for us by the Hanna Quartet from Munich. The first contestants in this string final of the Carl Nielsen International Chamber Music Competition 2023. A bold choice of repertoire, but they certainly carried it off, and they have given us that sort of level of musicianship all week here in Copenhagen. Absolute conviction, total technical control, and a sense of four players completely bound on a single vision of the piece they happen to be playing. Well, we're going to take a short break now. In around 25 minutes, we'll hear from our next competitors, the Novo Quartet from here in Copenhagen. They give us more Beethoven, opus 59, number 2, and two more slices of Carl Nielsen, movements from his string quartet, opus 13. So until then, we'll say a brief goodbye and hope to see you back at a 20 past 6 local time.
Har I brug for, at de lige står der lidt, eller? Ja, så jeg lader godt. Så de bliver lige stående ind til det sidste. Er det vinklet nok? I er faktisk en lille smule i princippet, så lad os lige rykke det ned igen. Vi rykker der lige en lille mulighed.
bare lidt med.
Hvad var det, 19 var? Det var her.
Man må ikke grine,
når der ikke er sådan noget.
Nej, men det er også...
Men det må man godt alligevel.
Yes, welcome back to the Royal Danish Academy of Music's Concert Hall here in Copenhagen, where we're just about ready to hear from the second finalist in the String Quartet category of the Carl Nielsen International Chamber Music Competition 2023. And that finalist is the Novo Quartet. Now, this is, in a sense, the home team. They currently study in Vienna, but this quartet is from Copenhagen, and it met at this academy, and it was mentored for 4 years by Tim Fredriksson, professor of chamber music and vice principal of this very institution. Now, the Copenhagen, or the Royal Danish Academy of Music, wasn't always based here. This concert hall that you can see on your screen, which was inaugurated in 1945, once was home to the Danish Broadcasting Corporation, Denmark's radio, and it was also therefore home to the Danish National Symphony Orchestra. But the radio and the orchestra moved out in 2008, and in moved the Music Academy and the Copenhagen Philharmonic. Now, the Novo Quartet will bring us Beethoven, his String Quartet, Opus 59, number 2, and also from Carl Nielsen, his first String Quartet, Opus 13, in G minor, the third and fourth movements. It was notable in the first round that the Novo Quartet stood up, playing Haydn, the violinists and viola player at least. They played Nielsen's Opus 13 in that first round, so we've had a taste of their Nielsen before. They certainly took ownership of it, as only Danes can. They also played some fantastic Mendelssohn in the second round, full of ardor and passion and young person's joie de vivre, and some very arresting Bartok too. But Beethoven is a different prospect. The Opus 59 quartets, of course, the Razumovsky quartets, marked significant development in his progress as a composer for four string instruments. Like the Opus 132 quartet we just heard from the Hanna quartet, this quartet has a molto adagio slow movement that seems to carry a sort of profundity inside itself.
Thank you.
Beethoven's String Quartet, Opus 59, number 2. Given to us here by the Model Quartet from Copenhagen. Of course, that was in fact, Carl Nielsen, wasn't it? I think they changed the order of the pieces, and we heard Nielsen there. Now we're going to hear Beethoven. So that was Carl Nielsen's String Quartet number 13, Scherzo and Finale, and now for Beethoven, Opus 59, number 2.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
the presto finale from Beethoven's String Quartet, Opus 59, number 2. And that music just grows and grows in intensity, doesn't it? And builds up as it's driven forward by that three-note rocket motif towards the most complete transformation. Well, don't always believe what you read on the screen. Of course, the quartet changed the order that we were expecting them to play in and gave us Nielsen first and Beethoven second. Apologies for the confusion earlier. Well, that was the second performance from the string quartet out of three we're hearing today. There is one more quartet to hear from, the Kaleo Quartet from London. They will be playing another of Beethoven's Razumovsky String Quartet, Opus 59, number 3, the quartet that followed the one we've just heard, and indeed two movements from the same Opus 13 String Quartet by Carl Nielsen, the same two movements, in fact. But in the meantime, we're going to take a short break, and we hope to see you back here at 7:30 local time. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, welcome back, and it's time for our last string quartet, indeed our last ensemble performance of this five-day competition here in Copenhagen. We're at the Royal Danish Academy of Music's Concert Hall for this, the string quartet final of the Carl Nielsen competition 2023, and our final quartet hails from London, the Cleo Quartet. They met and were formed at the Seiji Ozawa International Chamber Music Academy in 2019 and currently hold a residency at Snape Maltings, the Britain Peers Festival in Aldborough, and are experienced competitors as well as festival performers and well-known, already established on the touring circuit. They're going to play another quartet from Beethoven's set of Razumovsky string quartets for us, this time number 3. Now, these quartets, first performed in 1807, really changed the game for string quartet writing. This one in particular alarmed quartets of the time with its textures, these long sustained pedal notes that were seen as maybe some sort of joke by string players. But this was Beethoven expanding the language of the genre. And as always in Beethoven, the pressures he heaps on quartet players are immense. So many changes in meter, so many shifts in mood and atmosphere. And in this particular quartet, the second movement Andante, music like nothing else in all Beethoven, according to the composer's biographer, William Kinderman. Dissonances, melodies and plucked notes laid over apparently bare, inert six in a bar rhythms, and as well as those Russian elements that Beethoven introduced in homage to Razumovsky, to which the quartet was dedicated. In the final movement, we have a fugue, this intense discussion of a 10-bar long theme, introduced by the four players at staggered intervals. And that leads to an outright musical whirlwind, which lunges into dissonances, into dances, and into these strange appearances of the key of D minor before a triumphant homecoming. So Beethoven's Opus 59, number 3, followed by the Scherzo and Finale from Nielsen's String Quartet, Opus 13.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hurtling Fugue that ends Beethoven's String Quartet, Opus 59, number 3. A colossal fugue subject of 10 bars, and I think the Cléo Quartet from London really enjoyed the speed and just the vigour of that music as it carried them along with it towards those two chords of 11 chords that end the piece. Now we'll hear Carl Nielsen from them, from his String Quartet, Opus 13, the Scherzo. Third movement, and then the finale. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, that's exuberant music and absolutely Carl Nielsen, unmistakably so. The scherzo and finale from his String Quartet Opus 13. And that extraordinarily dramatic music he gives to the first violinist who powers the last movement there, absolutely suiting the first violinist of the Cléo Quartet from London. And with that, they end this competition, at least the musical elements of it, because that was the last performance we'll hear. It's been a brilliant competition right from the start of the wind contest on Wednesday morning across town at the Danish Broadcasting Corporation. And what an ending there. Skill at the highest level and young quartets and quintets giving everything and showing just how versatile and musical and disciplined they are. Well, Huy Koch is back on the stage here at the Royal Danish Academy of Music and is explaining to the audience here that the jury is now going to head out and vote and deliver a verdict on the winner of the string competition. We have already, of course, heard that who has won the wind quintet competition. That was Ensemble Astera from Switzerland, winning £15,000. But we should, in 20 minutes or half an hour, have a winner of the string quartet competition. Also £15,000, £10,000 to second place and £5,000 to the third placed quartets. Euros, I should say, of course, not pounds, €15,000. Well, if you want to know who has won, then visit carlnielseninternational.dk. Or visit the Facebook page of the Carl Nielsen International Chamber Music Competition and the results will be posted there. But from the live stream, it's goodbye. It's been an absolute pleasure to have you with us. We hope you've enjoyed every second of it and that you'll join us for the next competition in 4 years' time. But from Copenhagen, it's goodbye.